Assalamu alaikum, I am Hamid Saeed, an international image and wardrobe consultant. But above and beyond all, I am a UAT graduate engineer, your fellow brother. So I want to talk to you about clothing today, dressing, more importantly, how an engineer should dress. So let me tell you a little bit of story about my days at UAT. You know, when I was, you know, roaming around these campuses and I was going to class and all that, I thought that, you know, I should dress the way I like to dress. And the way I used to dress was, I mean, I know that how everybody else dresses. I will come with a blazer, I'll come with a nice shirt, sometimes tie, and a nice dress slack, and, you know, a nice nice belt, nice shoes. So I knew that my colleagues and my friends are going to tease me. And they used to say, oh, you know, Hamid, you know, tell me, what's the occasion? Why are you so dressed up? And you know something, I wanted to give them a good answer, but I also wanted to shut them up. So I said to them, I said, you know, I dress this way because I want to feel good about myself. And at that time, I didn't know, you know, I probably made a very profound statement. So anyhow, we'll talk about how an engineer should dress. I mean, I did a total transformation. You know, I went from engineering, I went to, did my MBA, and then I did my, you know, I went to a fashion school, Fashion Institute of Technology in New York, and I became a designer. I became an image consultant. So I want to talk to you from heart to heart, you know, from engineer to engineer, that how I see how dressing impacts on an engineer. And you know, what problems do I see, and what the solutions are. Main problem I see with engineer is this, that they all think that dressing doesn't really matter. What matters the most is their skill set. I mean, skill set is very important, education is very important. But I tell you something, importance-wise, appearance has a lot to do with also, you know, how far you're going to go in your career and how, you know, high you're going to go. Let me share a couple of things with you. First of all, you know, the first impression is the last impression. You must have heard about that. Now, my interpretation, my take on this is this. When you walk into a room and before you utter a single word, there are four impressions or preconceived notions or whatever you want to call it, you know, the perception about you. There are four perceptions that are being made for about you or about anybody else. Number one, what's your socioeconomic level? I mean, people judge you by that, by the way you dress. And the second thing is that how successful you are. In other words, is that your dressing, the way you're dressed also reflects upon your success. And the third thing is that, you know, people judge you that how, you know, what could be your education level. I mean, are you a graduate? Are you a, you know, I mean, you have like kind of education which is like mid-level education, or you probably don't look educated. And the last thing is that, you know, what your status is and what your title might be with the company. So this is like before you utter a single word. And I'm sure that you have judged other people based on these standards and preconceived notions. But let me tell you this, if you have judged others, I got news for you. You are also being judged. So I would say that it's very important that what your first impression is, how do you project yourself, I think it's extremely important in terms of how high you're going to go into your careers. Now, based on all these things, while being in New York, I developed a concept which is called dressing for success or dress for success for various professions, and we'll talk about, you know, how engineers should dress. There are four components of my formula, dress for success formula. Number one is the coloration. Okay, now we are all like, you know, God-gifted, we have God-gifted coloration, eye color, hair color, skin tone. Everybody's, you know, built in a certain way. And everybody has their own pigmentation on coloration. So the point in that is that if you wear clothing in coloration which is compatible to your eye color, hair color, skin tone, then you will look good. This is a simple point. And if you don't, then obviously you're not going to look that great. And I'm sure that you have seen it with you and other people. Some days they look very good, and they get compliments. Oh, you look great. And other day they look like kind of lousy. And basically they feel good, but inside they feel good, but outside they don't look that great. And coloration has a lot to do with that. The second pillar of Dress for Success is that what your personality is. Okay, now there are people that they're flamboyant and they want to be center of attention, or they want to be in that position, or by default they're in that position that they need to speak and they need to present. For those people, I think they can wear a little bit loud clothing, loud styling and all of that, but many people, they say, oh, you know, leave me behind, and you know something, I don't want to be in the center stage. For those people, I think conservative dressing is very good. So that's the second pillar of my Dress for Success formula. The third is very important, and people ask me, okay, what styling is good for me? I always tell them that styling is dictated by your body type. Are you short? Are you tall? Are you heavy? I mean, what's your body type? Because that will dictate, you know, what kind of styling is going to look good on you. I mean, just imagine if a guy is like heavy and he comes to me, or he goes to a store or something like that, and he buys a, you know, slim fit suit. Now, with slim fit, what's going to happen is that all his things that he wants to hide, like tummy and, you know, his hips and shoulders and all that, they're going to become more prominent. So I don't think that slim fit is the right fit for him. So the body type dictates, and if you're short, I mean, you have to be in impeccable dressing and clothing. Everything must be very engineered, very, you know, precisely, because when you're short, everything shows. And when you're tall, I mean, you can carry a lot of styles and a lot of clothing, but important point is that your body type dictates, you know, the type of styling that you should wear. And then the final point is that, and this is where I have spent my last 20 some years, more than that, and training people and educating them on dressing, is that what do you do? What do you do for a living? Are you an engineer? Are you a doctor? Are you an architect? What's your position? Are you a CEO of a company? If you're a CEO of a company, you should look like you're a CEO of a company. Doesn't matter you're an engineering company. I mean, you could be in any industry, but if you are a CEO or president, or you're at that level, you should look like, you know, that you are arrived, you have arrived, and you look refined, you look successful, you look sophisticated, you look accomplished. But let's go back to the engineers, that how they should look. And first of all, what's the financial impact of if they look the part, and if they look very engineered, very precise, and if they follow those four principles that I just described, I think they're going to look great. And once they're going to look great, I think the financial rewards are there. I mean, they're going to, anybody that who says like, hey, you know, I don't care, and you know, I'm sitting in the back and back room, and you know, nobody sees me. First of all, I think that, you know, it's not correct. People are seeing you. I mean, in today's time and age, everybody's on Facebook, everybody's out there in the conference, here, there, you know, communicating with people. So I think that if you need to like really, really look great, I think you should follow those four pillars of the ones I just described. And I think that's going to be really, really good financial rewards if you dress the part. In other words, if you look professional. I think, in my point of view, engineers should look very precise, they should look engineered, they should look all the details. It's not that the jacket is very loose, the collar doesn't fit, the tie and all that doesn't match. I mean, imagine you are working on major projects, you're going to be working on major projects, and then the companies that who will hire you, or the companies that you work in, they're going to look at you, how you look. And if your look is not precise, if your look is not very detail oriented, I think that there's going to be some kind of questions that, you know, can this guy do the right job? So I think that with this myth that, you know, engineers, that it's all what's important is here and appearance doesn't matter, I think it's just not right, and this is something that's going to hurt you if you don't improve your appearance and if you don't look the part. I can help you. I am here at MM Alam Road. I, you know, very conveniently located. My phone number is 0322-3034. I'll repeat it again, 0322-3034. And because you're my engineer brothers, sisters, I mean, you can come to me, I can guide you, I can look at you, I can look at your body, I can look at, you know, your body type, I would say coloration, I would, you know, look at you, what your aspirations are, where you're gonna go in life, you know, with as career-wise, and I can definitely guide you and suggest, you know, the right suits, right colors, right shirts, right ties. So I hope that you'll come and see me. I have come to Pakistan to help, you know, a lot of people here that who needs dressing, styling, you know, help. And so I hope that you'll contact me. And I'm very privileged and honored to talk to you today and appreciate your time. And again, come see.